Notice, AnySins is completely inspired by the channel CinemaSins and their series Everything Wrong With. AnySins would have never been birthed without them.
Starting with the climax of the episode and then cutting to the beginning cliche. Also, holy shit, this opening.
Hey, Amino, you game?
Bad idea.
Dude, really?
He's not gonna be into it, trust me.
This is cool kids talk. Gee, I wonder who the main girl of this show is.
I'm what you might call a bystander, a casual observer.
Oh, we have a mentally weak character with a high voice? This looks like a job for Josh Grell. Narration. The Rock is there? What the fuck? This kid has too much time on his hands.
Don't get me wrong, I have friends. They just happen to be, well, kind of imaginary.
A group of people working for an anime company heard this line and said, "Yep, that sounds pretty good to me. This is not how imagination works." Giving 5 sins for this awful CG.
Yukiteru, a moment please. I am amending a finer point of causality.
And they brought poor John Swayze into this, didn't they? Assassin did not ask a random bitch's consent.
How could I? No. Just a freaky coincidence, that's all.
Even if it was a coincidence, the text was sent to you before 7:05 a.m., meaning it has not happened yet. That should be the part that you're worried about.
This can't be a coincidence. Wait a second. I've got the answers.
If these are texts made by Yuki in the future, how did he know the answers then, but not now? I seriously doubt the teacher released the answers to the test 10 minutes after they were done. Also, none of these texts are about random rocks in the street. Also, this is not how bullying works. Everyone is talking about him acting like a poser and big shot, but that doesn't make any sense because he doesn't talk to anyone or do anything. He doesn't have any physical features that most people tend to make fun of, like, you know, being fat or wearing braces, and they can't make fun of his personality either because he does not interact with people. He's just a completely average Joe. I mean, he wears a stupid beanie, but that's beside the point.
I completely and totally win at life.
This teacher is completely oblivious to Yuki's phone. Also, flip phones. It's a fucking penis.
You got a dead end, right?
How did you know that?
I saw it coming a mile away.
Well, a mile is a measurement of distance, not time, so.
You're kidding me. You've got one too?
Well, yeah, everyone has a fucking cell phone. This shit doesn't happen to me in real life.
This nutjob writes about me in her diary every 10 minutes on the friggin' dot?
You talk about fucking rocks! Also, CG Deus conveniently doesn't tell Yuki about the survival game, even though apparently Yuki is his favorite. Why the hell does Yuki carry darts with him? This was hardly a meeting, more so just an exposition dump. Why is the select button on the outside of the phone? Gee, I wonder if she's a main character. I'm a simple man. I see tits, I take off a sin. Also, who let this person into the school? Seriously, you're already fucking up English. Please don't fuck up French, too.
For you, sweetheart, anything.
Is this the fucking time to be making out? How did she set up this bomb field in the school without anyone finding out? Also, why not just blow up the entire fucking school? You obviously don't care about the hostages since you're already blowing up other classrooms. Just blow up everyone, including Yuki and Yuno, and be done with it.
I've officially made a very good life choice today. This is a breeze!
No one thinks this when bombs are exploding behind them! Random event puts characters on top of each other cliche.
But the truth is, I'd have given an eye not to be so cordoned off. I was just lonely, you know? I wanted to be the guy everybody liked, talk to that one girl.
Is this the fucking time for a therapy session?
Little Fury has the bombs programmed to go off en masse the second her heart stops.
This guy has a future diary about homicides, but still didn't warn the school to not let random strangers in.
Here's the deal. I'm after Amino. Pool your resources and deliver him to me like the good little drones you are, and hey, I'd have to disarm the bombs for a sec, huh?
Or you could have just broke his phone when you had it in your hand.
I'd stay right there if I were you. There's a minefield between us.
When the fuck did you plant a minefield?
They're monsters. They couldn't care less if Yuki lives or dies.
Yeah, because they want to fucking live.
I'm gonna die. I'm really gonna die.
Sure you are.
Your backstabbing friends can go with you. In 10 minutes, this place will go up like a munitions factory.
Why not just kill him now? What's with the random shoujo sparkly shit? You know it's perfectly okay after this jump. Stand by, Nikki. She literally farted out those missiles. Also, where the fuck did she pull those motorcycles out of? Awful CG amusement park. Glad to see we're getting random backstory on the serial killer.
You're not gonna try to use us as bait or anything, are you?
Well, here's the plan.
Oh yes, bait her to a fucking amusement park with a shit ton of possible hostages. That'll work well. How does that even work? So you're just drinking each other's saliva?
Survival is what I do. Winning is what I do.
Yeah, you definitely won that last fight, right? These kids are afraid of a haunted house, but we're smiling during a fucking terrorist attack. Boobs touching guy cliche.
What's the matter?
Well, this bathing suit doesn't quite fit.
This is not how women act, unfortunately. I want to see.
Here you go, I think.
Oh, you're a lifesaver.
Well, she is. That's her fucking job.
Oh, a planetarium. Let's go there.
No, thanks. I don't want to.
Uh-oh. Edgy backstory of a planetarium killing Yuki's parents or something coming up.
Why do you keep following me around all the time?
How come you didn't want to go to the planetarium?
Answering a question with a question.
Well, it's a little stupid.
Is that the writer's reaction when they wrote this script?
Why you gotta be so negative?
The cool kid's talk is very strong.
It was just a random moment, right? It can't mean... Look, you're sweet and all, but my gut tells me you're hiding something.
Well, no fucking shit if she brings up something that you don't remember. Obvious bad guy exposure is obvious.
Yeah, sorry about the lights. We're kinda off the grid at the moment.
So you basically just live without water, power, and every other necessity known to mankind? Obviously, this person cares very much about his facial identity, yet he didn't wear a bag picking her up. You know, it didn't bother burying these bodies.
The boy's done it, hasn't he? He's achieved the unthinkable.
Opening a door! Yeah, he's done it! Wait, how could have it been a happy end? There are still 9 other diary users out there.
Why were they even there? She was clearly trying to hide them.
No, she wasn't. Because if she wanted to hide them, she could have clearly hidden them.
Stop hovering, dammit.
Did this asshole just skip a fucking frog? How the hell do you have a future scroll?
What's the diary say about your death? I mean, the person coming for you.
One of the many limitations of the scroll, I fear. Of my enemy, it says nothing.
So basically, you can see everyone except the people that you actually need to know about.
What the hell's going on?
That's my line!
What would have happened if I hadn't run like hell last night? Would you have added me to your collection? You want me to trust you after what I've seen?
There are people murdering each other literally 10 feet around you, and you're seriously having a discussion about murder! Her scroll definitely should have been ruined by the water, and she should be dead right now.
Between you and her ladyship, there's no contest.
Screw you.
Oh, it's nothing personal. You see, in rock, paper, scissors, paper beats rock. Rock beats scissors, and scissors beat paper.
Apparently, we need an explanation of rock, paper, and scissors to say, yeah, your diary fucking sucks. They brought zombies into this.
Seriously, you know with an axe is not a good sign.
Anyone with an axe is not a good fucking sign.
Reckoning, reckoning, I will be there, reckoning.
Look, whoever's behind this is after 6, not us. And there's no reason we can't just ditch her.
Or just run out now, since, like, none of them are moving.
There are 2 worlds, one visible, one invisible. The second is a wellspring from which my misery flows in dark torrents.
Probably the most pretentious dialogue I've ever heard.
We lurch along the path of life, spine bent with sin. To unbind our burden, one must withdraw from the road.
Yes, we must purge our sins by placing 1,000 dicks inside this underage girl. Also, tragic childhood cliche. How is your mask sweating?
We will rock you. We will
psycho mode.
Implying that there are times when she's not psycho.
So get the hell out of Dodge already.
Yuki, someone's on the roof!
Why isn't their diaries telling them this? Why isn't Ninth dead yet? Generic plot twist number one.
We could do something about your virtue, if you'd like.
Every hot girl wants a random nobody cliche. Ew, that's not kosher.
Not about to bite the big one cuffed to a damn pig.
Fine, I'll take him off, but you gotta do something for me.
This cop is literally letting this terrorist roam free. Again.
The amusement park thing was a date to her?
No fucking shit, it's not like you made out countless times already.
What am I gonna do? I ran off like a total wuss without even trying to save her. I'm pathetic.
Yes. Yes, you fucking are.
No!
I want all the men to form a line. Testing, 1, 2. Listen up, first.
There's about to be a fire sale on Second's Maidenhood.
No!
Yes, I was raped by 1,000 dicks. Now I must make every girl be raped by those same 1,000 dicks. You know, to release their sins or some shit.
You stalk me, switch gears at the drop of a hat, your house has dead people in it. I mean, how's a guy supposed to feel about all that? Eh, who cares right now? Your house has dead people in it. Eh, who cares right now? Your house has dead people in it. Your house has dead people in it. Eh, who cares right now?
Yeah, who the fuck cares? She's only a murderer. Not suspicious at all! It seriously looks like Yuki's mom is coming on to him. Like she has the boob on shoulder cliche and everything. Yuno is dying to meet Yuki's mother, but decides to just go under the bed instead, so this predicament happens.
Some serious talent you got. Very impressive. This family could use a gal like you.
You think?
Oh, I'd love to get you in a fancy wedding dress.
Or something more traditional, maybe.
The mother just met this girl and decides that she's the right woman because she can cook. And that's sexist.
Birds and bees time.
Seal the deal.
Oh, wow.
Some lucky cheerleader make my son a man yet?
The mom asked if he got lucky while she was gone, but then says that it's time to talk about sex, which makes no sense chronologically.
And we're out. Of course.
Here you go. Sorry.
Get out!
Why was the bathroom door unlocked?
There's like 5 other rooms she could be crashing in besides mine.
All I ask is that you try to keep it down. Night-night. Have fun storming the castle.
No mom encourages their 14 to 15-year-old son to fuck the shit out of a girl she met that same day. And no 14-year-old boy denies his boner after given all of these opportunities.
My man has such a lovely, understanding mother. And here I thought I'd have to get ugly with her.
Yandere bitch is very yandere.
Get the drop on them easily. They can use their diaries in tandem to black out your options.
No 3-year-old has this vocabulary. Where the fuck did he get the poison?
I'm not gonna make it to her in time. Turbo!
You could have made it to the bathroom in the time it took for you to do all of that.
Grab your partners, do-si-da.
Wait, something's not right. This tomato is off. It's heavier than when I washed it.
I guess Yuki's diary that tells the future just went on vacation. Ninth is addicted to squirrels.
You're not gonna get the better of me that way. I'm far too clever for either of you.
They can literally just kill you right now. But that's obviously not gonna happen because no one kills anyone without 20 minutes of edge first.
At high noon, the gloves come off.
They brought poor Street Fighter into this, didn't they? I'm sorry, Capcom.
Hey, let's move to a new stage.
Also, why the hell does the stage matter? It's Street Fighter. Stages don't mean dick.
Just had to go with your instincts. This is exactly the kind of stupid thing I wanted to avoid.
I'm sorry, Yuki. I'm so sorry.
Look, it's okay.
What do you mean, it's okay? He literally just whack-a-moled your mom.
Find the diary and he'll probably overlook me cracking his mom's skull.
This delivery man isn't surprised at all that a 3-year-old came to the door to get a package.
You and I both know we're gonna go at each other like animals. Fine then. Be a bitch. How about I up the ante a little? You beat me, you get a prize. The antidote. We'll keep it simple and treat this like hide and seek. Find me and you get to save your stupid boyfriend. Let the gas overcome you and, well, I'll be the winner.
Or just wait her out and kill her, like what anyone else would do. This door wasn't locked, but all of the other doors and windows were. Also, another goddamn tragic backstory.
Better luck next time!
You know it doesn't die from this.
Damn it!
Don't worry, it's real. It's too late to pull a fast one on you now.
This kid heals Yuno, the murderer of him and his parents, and Yuki, even though he has no obligation to do so whatsoever.
A word of advice, kid. Kill her. There's only one winner to this game, so just deal with it.
Why does Ninth heal them? They literally have done nothing for her. Even then, isn't she a terrorist? Wasn't she trying to kill them like 2 episodes ago? Oh hey, it's Kaoru.
More than that, Ninth almost blew me to pieces because of what he did.
She could have with or without you. She's just an idiot.
Oh, Hinata, always intervening on behalf of the underdog. Of course, in this case, how are you supposed to know which of these two brutes that is? Knock it off, Mao.
Dialogue forces the use of these two kids' names, so the audience knows that they may have to give a shit about them. Guy trips and somehow sees girls' panties cliche. Also, this is a middle school, and this purple-haired bitch brings a camera to school. Because school is so exciting. Almost forgot, anime set in school cliche.
Don't you watch the news tour? A bunch of people have been totally slaughtered in this neighborhood the past couple weeks.
Forcing in the word totally, because that's totally how the cool kids talk.
Hey. Boom. Okay, bear with me, this is an awesome idea if you hear it out.
Also, this bitch completely forgets about the fact that this asshole pulled down her pants within the span of 2 minutes.
Oh shit, you can totally still see the blood! Official chalk outlines and everything!
That is effed up!
Hey, playing on the swings where multiple people were just murdered! Fun! Also, 90s montage cliche.
What exactly possessed you to break the ice with me in the first place?
You seem like someone I'd want to know.
Digging off a girl's pants is a great icebreaker.
Akase, how long have you been there?
Longer than you to go by your panting.
They brought poor Todd Habercorn into this, didn't they?
Don't take this wrong, but your shaking is adorable.
How can you take that right?
I don't understand. Why is this happening? We just wanted to see a crime scene! We just wanted to see a crime scene! We just wanted to see a crime scene!
This guy can afford steaks for all of his dogs, but still eats cup ramen for some reason. Reminding me that I'm a poor college student. Why did you just get surprised from the dogs? You've been in this building for a while already.
I can't just let my friends die.
Why the hell are you saying this asshole is your friend? Didn't you say you hated him literally a few hours ago? These mechanical dogs follow the golden principle of the attack one at a time cliche.
You are some piece of work, Amino.
Where the hell did she pull out that knife from? She's wearing a blouse and a skirt with no pockets. So this bitch is obviously the daughter of the dog owner, judging from the picture shown here. If that's the case, why did it show her being scared of the dogs that clearly belong to her? I get it's for the suspense and all, but it still makes zero sense. And I guess Yuki's phone went on a pizza break and forgot to inform his past self that Crop Top over here was the mastermind all along.
Don't get your panties in a wad, sister. I'm not after your little boyfriend. None of this crap was for either of you.
Why wouldn't you be after Yuki or Yuno? They'll have to try to kill your dad sooner or later.
His unrelenting knack for spying on me would suggest he has a diary.
He's nothing. You can't be serious.
Much as I long for us to start anew, the boy is an obstacle.
Just send a dog after him then!
As if luck has anything to do with it when I can tell the friggin' future. Really didn't think that through too carefully, did you, Sherlock?
You think it'll be as simple as all that? You're hardly the only one here for whom the future makes itself known.
Why is this nutcase so damn cocky all of a sudden?
You're acting cocky too, you dumb bitch!
It's actually in my left hand, so suck it. Hate the game, not the player.
It's in your left. Read them and weep.
How the hell did you...
Oh my god, he took a 50-50 chance and won? What are the odds? All right, literally fucking 50-50.
Them's the breaks, chickadee. Hand it over.
To hell with that. How about I hand over the kid instead? You got a problem with that? I agreed to your stupid game. No reason it's gotta end after one round.
No reason! It has to happen in the first place! Just threaten to slice Yuki's neck and you win! End of story! Most people would assume that a detective would have a shit ton of messages in his memo index. Also, where are these girls with pocketless skirts pulling out knives from?
You win, you get Amino's diary. I win, you become chew toys.
Hey, Hinata?
What?
Promise me something before we do this again. If we win, promise me you'll, Well, I'd like us to still be friends if that's okay.
I'm just gonna go ahead and add 50 sins here. Write down in the comments if you object to that. I don't think anyone will, though.
Whatever. And because you're such a doofus, I'll let you live regardless.
Yes, this is totally how murderers and victims actually act to each other.
Don't get me wrong, I've been glad for the help. It's just, I shouldn't have got you into this mess.
And I have to take off 5 sins because gay anime girls are saving anime.
Definitely the right.
That son of a bitch, how do you know?
It's a 50-50 chance, even if he didn't know!
It's not enough my dad's on the chopping block. Now you've got to take away my only friend in the entire world!
I'm sorry.
She literally had a knife to your neck, you idiot!
Alpha One! Resume the hunt! Rip them all to shreds!
Why didn't you just break his phone when you had it then? So Yuki and Yuno left Kaoru and What's-His-Face so that the dogs wouldn't be chasing after them. And over here, it shows that to be true. But as soon as Crop Top calls the mechanical dogs because she's in danger, the dogs immediately come right behind Yuki and Yuno as if they were there the whole time.
Yeah, that's my name. I would like to introduce you all to someone very special. This is Yuno Gasai. My, girlfriend.
Is this fucking happening?
All I ask is that you accept these people as my friends. You can start by apologizing to Mal.
Yes, go apologize to the girl that's literally gasping for air.
Hey, yeah, I'm kind of totally sorry that I kind of stabbed you in the rib. You want to go totally grab a slice and, like, twerk? That's what the cool kids say today, right?
I set you on the wrong trail.
The dad has been listening this whole time and still does not tell the dogs to go kill Yuki and Yuno. Or even Kaoru, who he was most worried about.
Mind if I inquire as to what precisely you are reading from?
What, this? It's called manga.
It's pronounced mango, you fucking weeb. Haha, the terrorist who murdered a ton of innocent kids is making a pouty face. That's funny, right?
But get this straight, all it is to me is something dry.
Whatever, you look cute.
This cop actually takes off the handcuffs and calls a terrorist who murdered a ton of children cute. And yes, we've finally seen Moe terrorists. Guy topples over and cops a feel cliche. Pun intended. Who could have fucking seen that coming?
I live in the real world. Not one decorated in pink.
Yes, you totally live in the real world, with mechanical dogs and made terrorists. Female character makes the male character a sandwich cliche. Which is sexist.
Oh, wowza!
Wowza?
Wow, looks like something only royalty would eat. Wanna taste how the other half lives?
Why not?
Actually, the term How the Other Half Lives, most notably known because of the book written by Jacob Riis, is a reference to poverty, not royalty.
Maybe we are a couple and I'm just too seized up with whatever the hell's wrong with me to admit it.
Probably. I mean, after all, you're trying to be friends with a girl who straight up tried to murder you.
As long as you both shall live.
Maybe.
It cuts to another scene without Yuki answering if he would fake marry Yuno or not.
Sure wish my husband would take a page from your enthusiasm.
What does he, do for a living?
Oh, he's a homicide detective.
Yeah, what a coincidence.
Did you go into that room?
What's the matter, my love? What's going on?
Very curious, this room. Have you seen inside?
You had no right to go poking around!
You did the same shit, you fucking moron!
Bizarre place for a bottomless pit. I'm serious, if I throw a rock in, I can't even hear it hit.
If the hole is as deep as Kaoru says, how did Yuno even get out of it after digging it?
You're a stabilizing influence on her.
How is murdering people for the sake of someone else stabilizing? Symbolism.
Kateru Amano and Yuno Gasai, both of them the ripe old age of 14. I want these little punks brought in, and I want them within 24 hours.
Generic plot twist number 2. Cops conveniently finding Yuki on the street is convenient.
Kinda my job to only kill bad guys. So I can't be the one to shoot you. One chamber left. Afraid it's just not your lucky day. Shit happens. It's not meant to be funny. Sorry, kid.
First of all, what was this asshole gonna do after he shot him? He had one bullet in his gun. It obviously couldn't have been in self-defense. Second of all, I'm pretty sure there would be cameras in that room. And third of all, Yuno hits Dread Cops over here perfectly in the hand on the first try. And then she has a clean shot of his head, but only manages to graze his ear after 3 shots. And finally, Yuno, this experienced killer, chooses to shoot him 3 times in the chest instead of in the head, where he was obviously wearing a bulletproof vest, so he still lives.
I should have tried harder to keep you under control.
Oh, Yuki. You're so sweet.
When running from the cops, fulfill your boner before doing literally anything else. Jumping off a building only to be saved by some unseen convenient object cliche. There is absolutely no need to show us Yuno pissing, but you still do it, cause hey, vaginas.
I can smell donuts.
Also, Yuki still smells donuts, even though Yuno's piss is permeating throughout the entire room.
Is that...
Kurisu's wife?
Yeah, we just need to stay in this place to survive. But we'll chase after the cop's wife, who's conveniently carrying donuts.
Fine, and I won't give you a reason to.
To hell with that! If I let you go first, you'll pull something sneaky.
Look, I give you my word, all right?
As if that's good for anything, and for your info, she's carrying a gun.
This girl is literally trying to blow us to pieces. She could have done it a while ago, but she didn't. But the point is, this is the perfect place for the worst timed comedic moment I've ever seen with some happy-go-lucky music.
Dumbass! Are you out of your damn mind?
Help somebody!
If Yuno could survive a jump from what looks to be the third or fourth story of a building, why can't they just jump down one story? They're not gonna die. The fact that Yuki's and Yuno's faces haven't been shown on the news is ridiculous. They have committed a gigantic felon and are carrying a gun. I don't care that they're in middle school.
The reason Kurisu nullified the pact and sent you both running for your lives.
I've only got one condition in return.
I still don't get why you would make a deal with him in the first place. If he intends on becoming God, he'll have to kill you eventually.
Tell him to get their asses in there, stat.
His voice definitely should be muffled and inaudible. Also, why is his mouth even wrapped? Only your ear was shot.
I'm starting to think I shortchanged her, calling her a stalker. I mean, she's on her own planet, yeah, but hell, my girl's committed.
No, that's not committed. That is straight up obsessed. Firstly, none of these cops shoot Yuno. Secondly, Yuno gets the nearly impossible shot between the bulletproof vest and mask this time. Meanwhile, she couldn't shoot Dread Cops before, while right in front of him, with no armor, and shooting three bullets. Thirdly, she does this impossible shot three times in a row. Did I mention the fact that she couldn't shoot Dread Cops in the head?
Now comes the part where I use my second best skill set.
Wait, so her diary doesn't allow her to pull out a helicopter out of her vagina like in episode 2? That is definitely the worst escape diary ever.
Well, go on, Yuno.
Don't worry, I've got this.
Where the fuck are Yuki's darts that he used to kill Edgy Krueger over here?
Before you came into my life, this world was pretty much dead to me. If we hadn't met, I wouldn't have made it as long as I did. We could be a family if we got married.
Literally gag me.
You psychotic little...
Dread Cops misses all of those bullets, and he is a certified officer.
How do I keep running into you?
How do I keep running into you? Uncalled for!
You literally pointed a gun at him. It was completely called- fuck it. Also, Dread Cops never noticed that the design of Yuki's grenade was of a flashbang and not a frag grenade. I played all 74 Call of Duties. I know this shit.
This time I got you!
All it is to me is something dry.
Whatever, you look cute.
This time I got you!
Whatever, you look cute.
What the fuck? You playing mind games with me?
No, how are you still?
The same way you're still alive, through the power of plot armor. Also, more gun convenience. Convenient wedding picture landing in front of Yuki is convenient.
Why have you been stalking me for a year if you're willing to let it end like this? We were going to be married.
I was just living in a dream.
I wasn't just calling you my girlfriend to appease you. You're gonna be my bride one day. Maybe it's all just been a dream to you, but to me, it's reality!
Holy fuck, you literally have second thoughts about her like every episode! And yes, you did make her your girlfriend to appease her! Have 30 sins, you poorly written fuck! Yuki has shit aim, but because he saw that wedding picture, the power of boners gives him better accuracy for some fucking reason. Also, where the hell is your bulletproof vest now? You were wearing it in the station. So were you coming here and said, yeah, I won't be needing this shit? This dude is still teaming up with the terrorist who killed dozens of kids.
For what it's worth, Yuki, I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay. Apparently making friends with murderers is what Yuki does best.
For what it's worth, Yuki, I'm sorry.
Doesn't mean much coming from a bastard like me, I know. But you're gonna win this game. I know it.
The plot conveniently waits for Dread Cops to finish his monologue before making him vanish.
Hey, you're gonna wind up losing this thing.
Thanks. Did anybody try to call me?
You got some spam, but I got rid of it.
She could have straight up said no. These two middle schoolers are acting normal, even though they've both attempted to murder people. Apple product placement.
The hospital bomber was Keigo Kurisu, or fourth.
How is this guy a police officer? The hospital bomber wasn't fourth. It was ninth. In fact, ninth told you to your face that it was her in the last episode.
I'm not an expert, but that looked pretty damn real to me.
Well, that's probably because it was real. That's the bomb I set on 4.
Just because they're hiding doesn't mean they don't need water and power. In other words,
we check the lights, and if they don't work, that means nobody's home.
But Yuno lives in a house with no power. What are you talking about? When did she ever need electricity?
Sorry about the lights. We're kind of off the grid at the moment.
I'm confident that's not the only trap she's laid out for us.
Dude, let's just call it a day, huh? I don't think we're gonna find Yuki in this one.
In all likelihood, your hunch is correct.
How is this hunch correct? Where else besides where Yuno is hiding would there be an axe swinging from an elevator?
She totally found Yuki in the hotel basement. Check it!
Totally and check it in the same fucking sentence. Help me. My ears are bleeding. Just end me. Please.
Yuki and Yuno might be hiding out in this town somewhere.
Are you serious?
I want to find Yuki, but I'm pretty sure I'm gonna need your help to do it.
Why the hell would we do that?
Because they can see into the future. If I send in cops, they'll run for it.
Also, what the fuck was the point in sending in middle schoolers again? Regardless if they send in cops or children, Yuno could still see the fucking future through Yuki's phone.
If you could hold the door open while I do, Kosaka, I'd be ever so much obliged.
You got it, I'm your man!
Why is this asshole so enthusiastic all of a sudden? He didn't give a shit about Yuki an hour ago. Also, wasn't this asshole's one job to watch the freaking door? Why the hell is he walking in?
It's gas.
Wait, like gas?
No, like chicken. No shit, like gas! I still have another half of the show to go.
I want all the men to form a line.